Grasshoppers, here we have 20 agaves. What is specific for them? They have small silver contacts on top of copper base. In this specific scenario, we have to find a way to remove the copper and to recover the silver from the contacts in a cost-effective way. Because if we go via the classic acid method to dissolve all this in nitric acid and recover silver, we may spend more money on acids than the price of the silver that we will recover at the end. Let's start. As a first step, I'll scrap all this and show you the contacts. I'll be back in a minute. Let me show you the result after 30 minutes of scrapping. So these are the contacts. Not sure how much it's visible on the camera, but mostly copper, you can see. Silver is just a little here. I will collect them in this small container and show you what I'll do next. Let's take the scale and use local pharmacy and grocery shop chemicals for this experiment. In this beaker, I put 20 grams of citric acid. I will add table salt, 10 grams. You should not be exact at about 10 grams. We are targeting, so 7, 10 grams and a little bit more. And this is hydrogen peroxide 6% solution. You can buy it from any pharmacy. It's used to disinfect, so easily accessible. In many videos, people work with 30% and more. It's not that easy to access 30%, but 3 and 6% you can find in every pharmacy. Let's pour it inside and wait a little until citric acid and table salt dissolve. As you can see, in about 10 minutes, the solution is perfectly transparent. Citric acid is dissolved, also table salt. So, all these three chemicals, hydrogen peroxide, 6%, citric acid and table salt by itself, I mean, they're freely salt, they're not dangerous, nothing can go with them. But when you mix them, and when the reaction with copper starts, you may end up with some very unpleasant gases to go out from this beaker. That's why, after you put inside all your contacts, I would recommend to put this beaker outside on open air and just forget for it for a couple of minutes. Reaction immediately started. That's the result we have. These are the clean contacts and this is the solution. Not sure if you can see this color on the camera, but that's nice blue solution, which means dissolved copper. I'll put it aside and let's focus to the contacts. After 30 minutes the reaction stopped, but it doesn't mean that all copper is cleaned. As you can see, some reddish color can be on part of the contacts can be seen. This reddish color most probably is from some remains of copper, but I'm out of peroxide, so I didn't have the chance to continue the reaction. But for the purpose of this video, I think we can clearly see the difference. I'll show pictures of these contacts after the process and of the contacts before the process, so you can clearly see the big difference. What else? Let's measure them. As I said in the beginning, this method works well when you have small contacts, when you need a cost-effective way to recover the silver. And that's the most cost-effective way I found so far, because I use table salt, citric acid, and peroxide, three chemicals that are widely available and super cheap. We have 7.73 grams of silver, or let's say 7.5. So if we are fighting for $4, then every cent spent matters. That's why I use this method. Thanks for watching, keep scrapping, and don't forget to recover your precious metals at the end. Here is the real value. Bye!